en baby.
I just wanted to find out whether this our fight for deforestation is something that we really mean it, or we are just paying lip service to it. Why am I saying this? Today, 28 March 2020, about 15 to 20 trucks loads of charcoal are on the road between Damango and Boli. And you can find out that one of the truck has all the necessary documentations. One has a document from Cloth Palace, Cloth Chief Palace. And it was a 300 Ghana Cedi document from the Cloth Chief Palace. One has a document from the Yabunra's Palace. The Yabunra on February 2017 placed a ban on everything, including charcoal. And we as natives, we as citizens, we as his legs, his ears, his mouth, you know, his soldiers, we've been following this through. But today, 28 March 2017 to 2020, you still find on the field, on the road, a Yabunra's Palace receipt that also took 300 CDs or about 400 CDs or so for a truckload of 400 bags of charcoal. From there, there is a receipt from GPRTU, Ghana Road, Private Road Transport, whatever. And they are also charging 200 CDs. I'm not sure I understand what the challenge is. Damango Gunjaland Youth Branch is also charging these trucks. And they also have a receipt which we have dated 26 or so. You know, from there we have a receipt from forestry. We have a conveyance from forestry. Forestry Commission has given a conveyance. So if you look at the people that are involved in this charcoal business, Clofora means that, Clough Chief's Palace means that that is the community from which they took it from. And the chief has legally given a receipt. It came and the Damango branch of the Gunjaland Youth has also given a receipt and took money. The Yabunra's Palace has also given a receipt and taken money. The Forestry Commission has given a receipt and taken money. GPRTU has given a receipt and taken money. I am calling on all these people to come out and defend or otherwise. Are these receipts genuine? Are this money coming to us? Is Yabunra's Palace aware that it has put a ban on all these forestation activities in February 2017 at the Gunja Traditional Council meeting in Iyapi, 3 years down the line? Is Gunjaland aware that Damango branch is still doing this business when the Gunjaland youth is out there fighting against deforestation? Is Clofora aware that Yabunra has put a ban on it? And I just got a receipt also WhatsApp to me by the charcoal dealers from Damango passing through Boli, and they also took a receipt, and they have a Boliora's receipt. Are these issues really getting to Boliora? Are they issues getting to Yabunra? Are they these issues getting to Clofora? Are they really getting to forestry? The question is that, are we sure we really doing these things? I'm calling on all these stakeholders and I'm showing these receipts so that all these people will see them and follow them and check. If they are not coming to them, then we need to do something about it. If they are coming to them, then we need to take off the band and allow this business so that, you know, people like us who do not matter in the society, when we see that, we will just allow it pass. But if you see a truck and you stop the truck like we did today, 28 March 2020, and they have a receipt from Clough, they have a receipt from Gunjaland Youth, Damango branch, they have a receipt from Yabunra's Palace, they have a receipt from forestry, they have a receipt from GPRT, they have a receipt from Boliora, I'm getting confused. I don't know whether what we have, the documents we have stating and issuing bans on these things are really true, or we are just trying to cover up and put people like us into trouble who will continue bothering these forestry people, who will continue bothering others and probably creating enemies for ourselves. I call on all these stakeholders, especially the Gunja Traditional Council. I call on the Gunja Land Youth. I'm calling on the National President and the National Secretary to bring to book the Gunja Land Youth Damango branch. Come together and let us see what this issue is. If we are supposed to leave it and deforest the area, let us all go ahead and deforest the area. If we are supposed to stop it, let's stop it. The District Assembly receipt was part of it. West Gunja Municipal Assembly had a receipt. They also took money. What are we doing? Is what we are saying what we are doing, or what we are doing, we are saying something different? For me, I need answers from all these, and I'm charging the Municipal Chief Executive for Damango to come up and say something about these things and something about these receipts that we're showing in this video. For me, it is frustrating and it is very terrible that we come up as lawmakers, as landowners, as, you know, law enforcers, as forestry managers, and we still continue to do these things in the wake or in the, you know, scene of bans upon bans. I just get confused. And this afternoon, I'm really, really getting a bit disappointed. I don't really know whether what I'm doing is right or what I'm doing is wrong. I need answers from all these stakeholders.